Welcome back to another video. My name is Adam from WPCrafter.com, where I make WordPress videos for non-techies. And in this video, I want to maybe go over some creative uses for the slide module for Elementor Pro. So here is the website for Elementor Pro. If you don't already have it, it is the fastest page builder for WordPress. They have a free version and a paid version. However, the slide module that I'm going to talk about in this video is only available in the paid version of Elementor Pro. Got some good news for you though. I have a coupon code that I'll tell you about at the end, and I have a special bonus offer that I'm also including with Elementor Pro if you did decide to purchase it. But let's just take a look at it. So there's some new features that were just added to the slide Pro element in Elementor. So slides is essentially a slideshow. So we can just drag it there and it's going to populate a slideshow here for us. But there's a new feature that was recently added, and that's to give you something called the Ken Burns effect. And this is an effect where you can take an image and it can move at whatever speed that you want it to move. And I'm going to show you how to use that in this video. So first, what we need to do, it's not going to really work on a solid color background like this. It's really made for images. So I'm going to go ahead and click on the first slide, and instead of a background color, I'm going to choose background image. And I probably have a few background images here. Let's see. I know this one's pretty large, so let's just go ahead and insert that there. So we have our background image here, and here's this new option right there. It says Ken Burns effect. So I'm going to go ahead and turn that on. Now, when you turn it on, you already start seeing the image move. Now, right now, the only options are in or out. So that was the motion of it moving in, and then you could change this to out, and then it's going to give you a slight movement there. Now, what determines how long it moves for is the amount of time that you have in between the slides. So if it's 5 seconds, it's going to move for 5 seconds, and it's going to kind of move at a faster pace. There isn't a control here of the speed. It's really dictated on the amount of time that you leave in between slides. So lastly, I would probably put maybe an overlay color like that just to darken it up a little, but you can use whatever color you want. So let's go ahead and go to slider options, and let's play away around with this autoplay speed. So right now it's set to 5 seconds, and that's why you're seeing that a bit of movement right there. But when I was playing around with it, I tried 20 seconds like that. So look at what that does. It gives you a nice, subtle, slower movement in on the picture like that. And I really like that effect right there. So that is one creative, new creative use for this slideshow. Now, another thought I had, and I'm just going to go completely off the cuff in this video. If you just wanted to have some random movement on your website, let's try it out. So say I had a section like this, where you had two columns. You had an image on one side and maybe just some informational text on the other side. So let's see what we could do to have a little movement in an image that we might want to put there. So I'm going to go back to my Pro Elements, and I'm going to drag in that slide again, but this time it's just going to be in this one little box right here, and then we'd probably want to put some kind of text over here on the right. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to go ahead and swap this out for some images. So I'm going to go and put an image there. I'm going to click on slide 2. I'm going to put a different image, and not that one. Let's go with this pizza right there. And then for slide 3, I'm going to go ahead and choose another image like that. So we have our images there. So let's go back to slide 1 right here. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to turn on the Ken Burns effect like that. And let's see, I'll start with going out. And then I'm going to scroll up here where it says content. And I'm literally just going to remove all of the content like that. So I just have an image there with this motion, and I'll get rid of these arrows. So I'm going to do that for each of these slides. I'm going to just remove all the content for each of them just like that. And I'm going to turn my Ken Burns on here. And instead of out, I'm going to go in. So I'm going to alternate it. Okay, I'm on the third slide doing the same thing here. And on this one, I'm going to do a Ken Burns and I'm going to go out. So it's going to be out, in, out. Now what I want to do is go down here to my slider options and I want to get rid of these arrows and dots and make it none, just like that. And the last thing is that speed is a little too much for me. So I'm going to go ahead and enter 20. So each slide's going to be 20 milliseconds. And so there you can see how nice that is. So we're able to take this slideshow module and we're able to use it to have some nice subtle motion on our website. It's not technically a slider, your typical slider where you have all these things moving and text showing and buttons and all that, but you're able to use it for a really nice, elegant effect that ends up being very subtle, like you see here. So let's try to get that back onto the first slide. I'm going to go to slides, click on slide one. Let's see, slide two. So slide one was in, slide two was out, and slide three, just like that. So now let's try that one more time. So you've got this beautiful movement now on your website to make the website come alive a little bit. Honestly, I'll tell you, I'm happy that Elementor Pro includes a slider because that's one less thing you have to buy, one less interface you have to learn, one less learning curve you have to go through. But to tell you the truth, I'm not really the biggest fan of sliders themselves. I know that customers and clients, they want that, but I tend to not be the biggest fan of sliders. I much rather use a slider in a more subtle way that you saw me do right here. But this is just to show you that just because a module is made for one purpose, you can use it for lots of different things too. And this is a real elegant way to get some nice movement in your website, especially if it's like a restaurant or something like that where it's very visual and the pictures really sell it. So this was just a creative use of this new feature that is available in the Slides Pro element that comes with Elementor. Now here's Elementor's website right here. I have a link down below in the pinned comment and I also have a link in the description below. And here's what I'm going to do. If you wanted to purchase Elementor, go ahead and click on my link and they have been generous enough to give a coupon discount to the viewers of my channel. So when you go to Elementor Pro's website and you choose a package, when you're checking out, you can enter the coupon code WPCrafter10. And guess what? That's going to take 10% off your purchase. But that's not all. I'm going to do something special for you because I want you to be successful using Elementor. I've created a training course on Elementor and it's called Elementor Essentials. It's available for sale for $97. But if you purchase Elementor through the link in this video, I'm going to enroll you for free into this training course, which is a complete website building success system that's going to take anyone that wants to build a website, give them all the tools and knowledge necessary to build an amazing website using Elementor. And it's a very in-depth training program that I'm sure you're going to get a lot of benefit out of. It's going to take your learning curve and flatten it out and essentially allow you to build a better website faster. Because you made it to the end of the video, I have a free gift for you. But before I talk about that, I want to ask you to do something for me. If you could give this video a thumbs up down below, that would really help me out. If you're not subscribed to the channel, go ahead and click on that subscribe button and become a subscriber and support this channel. And if you'd like YouTube to notify you when I upload new videos, there's a little bell next to that subscribe button. You can click on that and set that up as well. If you have any questions or a comment about this video, I'd love to answer it. There's a comment section down below. All you have to do is put in your question or comment. I respond to every single one. Hey, I made a course just for you, and it's called The 3 Steps to WordPress Success, and I want to give this to you. If you'd like to enroll in this course, there's a button right here off to the right. You can go ahead and click on that, enroll as a student, and that's just my way of saying thank you for supporting me and making it to the end of this video. I make them just for you.